There's your white breast. And so, you know, you can see, if you look, there's, you know, just these kind of maybe little dots kind of. And then here is the left. Okay, same kind of thing. What you have are all these little bitty things.
That's a little scary.
No, it's not scary. I mean, again, we're just looking a little harder.
Today is Judith Millard's second appointment with breast cancer surgeon Laura Esselman at the University of California San Francisco Medical Center. In early July of this year, the 69-year-old was diagnosed with ductal carcinoma in situ, or DCIS, a type of precancerous lesion often referred to as stage zero breast cancer. The first breast surgeon she went to suggested the standard treatment for DCIS, surgery to take out the tumor, followed by weeks of radiation. It's the same treatment protocol used for many invasive cancers. But Mrs. Millard decided to seek a second opinion. In her search for a less aggressive alternative, she found Dr. Esselman.
So it could all just completely go away. If in three months, in 6 months, you have nothing there, we're never going to operate. If it all goes away.
Dr. Esselman is part of a group of cancer experts in the U.S. who say cancer is being overdiagnosed and overtreated.
Most people think if they're told they have cancer that they have a disease that's going to kill them. I mean, uniformly, it strikes fear into people's hearts. The word cancer actually encompasses a whole range of biologic conditions, from things that can be very slow-growing or indolent, and in fact maybe would never come to clinical attention if we didn't find them, to lesions that grow very quickly and can progress and cause death.
When cancer screening increased rapidly 3 decades ago, the goal was to detect cancer at its earliest stages to reduce the rate of late-stage disease and mortality. But intensive screening is identifying not only lethal cancers, but also low-risk lesions that are treated with the same methods. Dr. Esselman and other scientists say early diagnosis has not led to a proportional decline in serious illness and death. Instead, they argue intensive screening is identifying not only lethal cancers, but also low-risk lesions that aren't likely to progress. DCIS is one of the diseases that often don't pose an urgent health threat, says Dr. Esselman. But while most doctors prescribe surgery and in some cases radiation for DCIS patients, Dr. Esselman is treating some, including Judith Millard, with only a hormonal medication that can shrink the tumor. Mrs. Millard says she was surprised when she first found out her disease might be cured this easily.
I was elated, followed by shocked. Followed by, let me think some more about this, because she said, I absolutely wouldn't do surgery. And it just, you know, it was the last thing I expected to hear. But you go back and you start doing more research and you make peace with the process.
About 230,000 women are diagnosed with invasive breast cancer annually in the United States and around 50,000 with DCIS. In patients with DCIS, abnormal cells are contained within the milk ducts. Sometimes the condition evolves into invasive cancer. Data shows that the rate of in situ or non-invasive lesions has increased about 7 times since 1975, while the incidence of invasive cancer has not decreased. Theoretically, finding and treating more DCIS patients should reduce the number of late-stage cancers because those early lesions wouldn't have a chance to spread. But this data indicates, Dr. Esselman believes, that most DCIS cases cannot be precursors of invasive cancer. So why treat them that way?
The trick is now to figure out, so which are the ones that we can treat less aggressively? Or where can we start offering some different options? Where are these really just opportunities for prevention? And where are things, and where are they in fact just lesions we can just leave alone?
Dr. Esselman wants to reduce overdiagnosis of DCIS and other low-risk lesions nationwide by refining screening practices for patients and tracking cancers in registries. Ultimately, the key is to find ways to avoid overtreating tumors that are not likely to progress, she says.
Happy days.
Yeah. Yeah. Happy. Family.
Mrs. Millard is one of the DCIS patients in the registry who are given a choice to be monitored with or without hormone therapy. Mrs. Millard's therapy over the next 6 months includes a daily dose of the aromatase inhibitor letrozole and surveillance, including 2 MRIs, one after 3 months and one at the end of the test period, to see whether her 2 mm tumor has changed. UCSF's DCIS registry is part of a larger study that will involve more than 100,000 women who are screened for breast cancer at different intervals and followed for years through the five University of California medical centers. Dr. Esserman has applied for a $10 million grant for the study. In exchange for providing detailed information about their health history and hereditary factors, the patients receive a risk assessment on which their routine of screening and treatment will be based.
Do less where it's appropriate to do less. Do more where it's appropriate to do more. The most important thing is to tailor your treatment to biology and then ultimately to the outcomes. And that has to be a continuous learning cycle. That's how you make change.
Many doctors in the U.S. would agree that change to improve how cancer is diagnosed and treated is a good thing. But while they support Dr. Esserman's trial, they caution about adopting her approach too early.
I applaud her efforts because we may learn a lot more about the biology of the disease. But I think that it's too soon to advocate this as an approach that can be generalized to the entire country or to the world. And I have found that most women that present with DCIS want to keep themselves safe and healthy and don't want to run the risk of having this come back again.
Dr. Esserman and her colleagues have been harshly criticized for their claim that early detection and treatment don't always save lives and result in unnecessary treatment. Other experts say current strategies in breast cancer care have saved lives and that not enough is known about how cancers progress to leave some untreated.
If we continue to say we don't know enough, we'll never know enough. I say we know enough now to make some changes and test a new approach. And that's why you test it. And to say that we can't do a better job is ridiculous. The aggregate cost of screening mammography in this country is somewhere in the $8 to $10 billion range. And I think that we could probably do just as good a job and cut that number in half. That's what you call healthcare value. And then we can put some of that effort into improving our treatments. And I would say it's way too risky not to try and do new things.
For Judith Millard, Dr. Esserman says watching and waiting for 6 months doesn't pose much of a risk, but can lead to a better outcome. DCIS patients have a higher chance of developing invasive cancer within 5 to 10 years, so a few months won't make a difference, she says. Dr. Esserman told Mrs. Millard that 1 in 4 patients see their tumors disappear completely after taking the medication. Mrs. Millard says she's ready to try her luck.
I'm fine with that chance. You know, I feel like I have a 6-month reprieve to have my life go on as usual in peak health with no symptoms, and I know that it's being totally controlled. So I am very comfortable with waiting 6 months, and if we have to go back to surgery at that time, as the answer, then so be it.